what are conventions? Why do we have them? Why do we need them? You know, when you start with a civilized society, you need rules, you need regulations, you need a system wherein people bases the present technology, the present situations, the present ideas. They need to have a system where the society becomes just, you know, where everybody is treated as an equal, everybody has opportunities, and that is based on practicality and the technology of the moment. Now, as you advance, your conventions, your rules, they need to get changed, right? Because unless you change them, there's no point on advancement, right? So, but, and here's where the problem comes. All of us, and that goes for every human being, we're so used to being a certain person in a defined set. We all have our identity basis, what is there at that moment, or what was there when we were born, or when we grew up. And when the world around us changes, we don't know how to project ourselves, and we don't know how to define ourselves in that changing environment, and hence, we don't want to let go of any of those conventions that we've got, any of those ideas that we've got, any of those theories that we've built for ourselves. Because, you know, that shakes our place in the world. See, this whole world, this whole society, the reason that you live is a lot to do with your self-identity, your place in the world, and that's what keeps you going, that's what keeps you awake in a day. And when that changes, you don't know what to do. And hence, as human beings, as people, we don't want to let go. And so the whole point of redefining comes in, because I don't want to redefine something to an unknown, right? I want to stick to what I know. I want to stick to what I can see my place in. And here is where our problem comes in. And that's when we pigeonhole people. That's when we decide that I think this person should be this. I think this person can do this, because that's what helps me identify my place in the world. You know, we're all relative to each other, right? We all put ourselves as relative. And as students, you're the best people to know that. You all place yourself relative to your classmates, relative to your batchmates, relative to people in other campuses. So it's a relative world. And that's when you don't want to give someone else an opportunity which might put them at a better pedestal than you wanted them to be at. And that's when the problem arises. That's when the conventions become a problem. That's when they, you know, the social fabric doesn't become the fabric that it's meant to be. It's supposed to be elastic. It's supposed to help you change. It's supposed to help you grow. But the minute you decide that, no, this new technology, this new idea is going to change my place and to the detriment of yourself, and you don't want to give other people that opportunity, and that's where your problem comes in. So it's all a lot to do with your confidence in who you are, and hence your, you know, this place that you've got in your head and this idea that you've got of yourself, and so you don't want to let go and you don't want to let other people into the place. And strangely, my life was a lot defined by that, and actually in this campus the most, you know. This is where I first faced the idea that you have been pigeonholed and you have been put into a place, you have been put into a slot, and that's where you're supposed to stay. And the minute you start escaping out of that, you start climbing out of that, and the minute you start doing something which other people don't think you should be doing, the problem started. But you know what? So being on the side of the person who was breaking out, it was excellent, because I got to learn, I got to grow, I got to fight, and I got to try to define my place in the world. And that makes you stronger. It's a good thing for you if you are the one who's escaping, because then the world, you see the world for what it is, and you introspect into yourself, and you realize that you're probably the person who might have been doing that to others as well. And that's when you learn how to grow and learn how to change your own attitude and learn how to not do that to others. And that was my biggest learning from this campus. That was the main thing I got from here. How to realize in yourself that you've been pigeonholed and you've been doing that to other people, and to stop doing that. And campuses, the situation that you're in, this is the best place to learn that. And this is the best place to understand that each of us has capabilities that others may not see, and each of us has a place in the world that you need to start building for yourself. And don't let other people tell you what your place is. Don't let other people define that, because you have, over the years, this is what you should have been doing, and that's what you should do in future. let's not do that to each other as well, and let's not allow others to do that to ourselves, right? Because the minute you say that this person is supposed to be just this, and this is their role in life, this is what they're supposed to be doing, that's the minute you close down all avenues for growth. That's when your society stops developing, that's when your country stops developing, that's when you stop developing. It's about letting each other explore ourselves, it's about letting other people explore themselves, giving a platform to this world, giving a platform to each other. And if you as a person, if you as a country, if you as a society, if you as a campus have to grow, we have to understand that we can't pigeonhole ourselves, and we can't let other people pigeonhole us and tell us what you can do and what you can't do. The minute you do that, you set boundaries on your own limitations and you set boundaries on other people's limitations. And instead of being insecure and seeing other people's success as something to be afraid of, why don't we start working on our own self? And why don't we start working on building ourselves into a better person, or building ourselves into a stronger, more humane, or more, a person with better capabilities, a better person with better skills, better ideas. So conventions are a great thing because they help each society be a just society, gives a framework to the society, gives people an idea of what they could relatively be doing in position to others. But let that not be a point where it stops you from growing. Let that not be the framework which is settled and doesn't have expansive, elastic boundaries. You're engineers, you should understand elasticity, right? So that's when the problem starts. That's when your, the situation becomes terrible, and that's where you need to change. So the whole point of conventions is that it worked at that particular point in time. It has to evolve, it has to change, it has to grow with you. And let's do that. Let's all not have conventions which are static, and let's not have this need of redefining them. Let the convention itself be that we're all different, we're all allowed to grow, and we're all allowed to discover who we want to become, and let's all be people who can change and grow and, evolve into whatever we want to be. Let's not put people into slots and decide on their capabilities, decide what they're capable of, and decide what they should be doing. And in fact, this word of should, especially where women come, this should is like such a big thing in our lives. There's no should. All human beings were born equals. We were all born with some capabilities, something that we were going to be good at. Let's give each other the opportunity, and let's give ourselves the opportunity of doing that, okay? Thank you so much, and I hope we live in a world where the need of redefining doesn't exist. The convention itself is that we all get to explore and change. Thank you.